What were you doing when you were 16 years old? Not to brag, but I was playing for my high school team and maybe even scoring a goal or two. But instead of boring you with my storied athletic career, I guess we should be talking about the latest La Masia youngster to make the jump from the academy to the first team. It's 16-year-old Ansu Fati. Fati isn't the only player to make his debut as a teenager, so today we're looking at the other prodigies that made their first appearance before adulthood. Hi, I'm Dan Hilton, and this is the Barcelona Podcast, YouTube exclusive. Let's start with the players that made their debut prior to the Liga era in official competition. We start with Albert Amasque, who was just 13 years old when he debuted for the first team in a Copa Macaya tie against España in 1901. Next up was Armando Martinez Sagi, who debuted for the club in 1920 as a 14-year-old in the Copa del Rey. He was a role player for the club, playing from 1919 to 1923. He was also a world champion billiard player, and probably most notably, he was a brother of Ana Maria Martinez, the first female director of FC Barcelona and the first in Spanish football history. Paulino Alcantara, the prolific goal scorer from Barcelona's early years, doesn't officially get recognized for his debut due to the era that he played in. Born in the Philippines, he moved to Barcelona at the age of 3. He was discovered by Juan Gamper and joined the Barcelona youth system, eventually debuting for the club at the age of 15 in 1912 in the Campionat de Catalunya. If we're strictly talking La Liga, Ansu Fati is second on the list, only behind Vicente Martinez Alama. Martinez debuted against Real Madrid in a 4-3 loss in October of 1941. It was a tough season for the Blaugrana as they finished 12th in the league, though they did win the Copa del Generalísimo. Though he came from a boxing family, he felt the pull of football. He dealt with a number of injuries and couldn't make the grade, though he did continue his career for a number of years playing for Catalan clubs. And that brings us to Ansu Fati. Born in 2002 in Guinea-Bissau, his family moved to Herrera, Seville when he was 3 years old. He followed his older brother Brahima's lead and began playing for Sevilla's youth teams before the duo moved to La Masia in 2012. In his first season at the club, he scored 56 goals in 29 league games for Alavín A, alongside Takefusa Kubo. In December of 2015, he suffered a broken tibia and fibula in his right leg playing against Espanyol. The injury came after he was investigated and held out of practice due to Barcelona's FIFA ban. When he returned to the field 10 months later, he came back better than ever. He has starred at every level even while playing up age groups, including last season at Juvenil A. He shined for Barça B during the preseason, and while he has yet to make his official debut for Francisco Pimienta's side, his performance against Real Betis showcased only the surface of his potential. There are a bunch of names that will be familiar with modern culés, starting with Bojan Krkić. Debuting for the club at the age of 17 years, just 19 days after his birthday in a 0-0 draw against Osasuna in 2007. While he played in over 160 games for the club and scored more than 40 goals, culés know his story. He never replicated his debut season of 12 goals and moved to Roma in 2011. Stops in the Italian capital, followed by moves to AC Milan, Ajax, Stoke City, Mons, Alaves, and currently with the Montreal Impact of MLS, have made Bojan quite the journeyman. Speaking of Stoke City, Marc Manresa, who made his Barcelona debut at the age of 17 years, 1 month and 26 days in a 1-0 loss to Osasuna in 2009, also made his way to Stoke City. He moved there in 2013, and in 2017 he played for Girona on loan before making the move official the following season. As of a few weeks ago, he is now playing for Al Arabi in Qatar. Fun fact, he is joining up with Xavi Torres, who started in midfield in Muniesa's debut match. We're going to round out the top 5 with an unsurprising name. October 16, 2004, Lionel Messi debuted for FC Barcelona in a 1-0 win over Espanyol at the age of 17 years, 3 months, and 22 days. He came off the bench for the match's goal scorer Deco in the 82nd minute and played alongside Andres Iniesta, also a substitute in the game, Xavi, Ronaldinho, Carlos Puyol, and Victor Valdez for the very first time. On the bench that day was Ruben Martinez, the current goalkeeper for Osasuna. For Espanyol, they lined up with Messi's friend Maxi Rodriguez, currently with their local Argentine club Newell's Old Boys on the right wing, and current Tottenham manager Mauricio Pochettino at center back. His one goal that season came on the 34th match day against Albacete, when he came on for Samuel Eto'o in the 88th minute and scored in the 91st. He would have a few more in a Barcelona shirt since then. Before we wrap things up, I want to give a quick mention to the other 8 players that debuted for Barcelona's first team before their 18th birthdays. Center back Nano, better known for his days at Racing Ferrol and Numancia, played just 6 games in the shirt after arriving on the scene in 1999. Center forward Oriol Riera who is currently leading the line for CF Fuenlabrada in their maiden campaign in the second division, played only that one match in 2003 for Barcelona's first team, a 4-0 win in the Copa del Rey over Ciudad Murcia. Let's turn back the clock for the next one for forward Alonso Navarro, making his debut in a 2-0 win over Real Oviedo in October of 1946. The winger from Gava would make 33 total appearances for the club, actually moving to Real Madrid for just the 1950-51 season, before stops at Real Valladolid, Osasuna, a return to Barcelona, the now defunct Club Deportivo Condal, and Girona. A more recent winger is up next, Gerard Deulofeu. He was already a known commodity to culés when they debuted against Mallorca in 2011 due to his incredible numbers in the Masia, but he was another promising prodigy that never made the grade in Catalonia. 2 goals in 23 appearances made way for stops at Everton, twice, Sevilla, AC Milan, and current home Watford. Still only 25, Deulofeu's career hasn't been a failure by any means, and hopefully Watford can be a permanent home for him in the Premier League. Also currently in the Premier League is Wolverhampton's 23-year-old winger, Adama Traore. His story is similar to Deulofeu's, as the winger has made stops at Aston Villa and Middlesbrough before finding his current home in the West Midlands. Only 3 appearances followed his debut in a 4-0 win over Granada in 2013 for La Blaugrana. Right wingers have taken over our list, and that continues with the next entry, Ángel Pedraza, playing for the club in the 1980s before moving to Mallorca in the first half of the 1990s. He debuted against Liema Wanderers, a side from Malta, in a 2-0 win in the first round of the UEFA Cup. It would take 5 more seasons before he finally cracked the first team on a consistent basis. The final 2 17-year-olds, Puyol, not that Puyol, and Mario Rosas, played in a combined 18 matches for the club. Puyol made his appearances in the 1960s and 1970s, while Rosas made his 5 appearances between 1997 and 1999. Some of the notable 18-year-olds who just didn't make the cut include Thiago Alcantara, Carlos Reschak, Giovanni Dos Santos, Iniesta, Xavi, Rafinha, and Carlos Alenya. So not everybody on this list turned out like Messi, and many on this list barely made an impact with the first team. But debuting for FC Barcelona as a teenager is still a tremendous accomplishment that can make a career. With his debut behind him, I for one am very interested to see what historic list Ansu Fati finds himself on next. For more on him, check out this week's episode of the Barcelona Podcast, and if you like this video, keep checking this channel and don't forget to like and subscribe. Until next time, Forza Barça!